We understand that it was a rather close vote among the executive committee members. We've heard 8-5 or something like that. Do you expect a real fight next week?
I have no way of knowing, Teel. I think that with the explanations that have been given to the executive committee tonight and the discussion we've had when it's been brought to the whole board, I would be most hopeful that the whole board would go along with the executive committee, and I would be confident that they would.
Did Commissioner Whittington and Mr. Coker give you any indication of what might be the tone of acceptance of the judge and the investigating committee?
Why, all that we've said here is wholly compatible with the report, so I anticipate no problem at all.
What if they don't accept this?
That wouldn't follow, because this is completely compatible with the city-county report, only in these particulars where there was a deviation from OEO guidelines, and I think they've already expressed themselves as being perfectly willing to go along with the OEO guidelines. So there's no difference. There's no difference.
You seem
we have reached full harmony. We have reached full harmony. And there's no point in trying to find a difference because it isn't there.
I feel much better. In fact, I'm well pleased, and I'm pleased with the exec committee. I think it's real good. Of course, we will have some conversation, and of course, we know where that comes from. Snake and Black Panther's not going to give up easily. Now, you know that, too.
Do you think you'll be able to work with Dean Galvin?
Lord, yes, we can work with anybody as long as we set it up on a business-like basis.
The efforts of Ross Perot to bring relief to the prisoners held presently by the communists and also to bring the attention of the American public to the plight of the prisoners, has this had an effective reaction?
I think so, because, again, the Viet Cong and North Vietnamese are very responsive to American public opinion. They've stated as much that they don't expect a military victory, nor do they expect an immediate political victory. But through influencing American public opinion, they can force us to withdraw prematurely. This is the key to their success, or their hope for success, so that they're very responsive to it. And the fact that I believe the war itself is debatable. There are so many sides to it that there's no way to say it's either right, wrong, or in between. But the plight of the American POWs is not debatable. And this is one issue behind which all of the American people should be united. And if the North Vietnamese and the Viet Cong find that the American public opinion is being united against them because of their treatment of our POWs, then it reaches a point where it's one of diminishing returns. And our POWs will, in the long run, I think, benefit from this move.
in the outright firing of both or one of the parties, or could they be incorporated under the new rules if they were so willing?
Of course, a new board could incorporate him and under the new rules, but this is the first time, and I've been in government most of my adult life, that I have ever seen the civic leadership of Dallas. And those people refer to as a silent majority just began to become vocal. You're familiar with the many, many letters, the many petitions and telegrams demanding that the city and county solve this problem. Now, I don't think we would be permitted, if we so desired, to keep it as it is today.
How do you feel now? What is your mental attitude about the whole war on poverty question? Biggest problem you'll have to face now?
It doesn't seem to be too great a problem. To me, it's been very simple all along. The programs, the hiring of the employees, if you just use a little integrity and examine the programs for character, and is this the best thing to do? To me, that isn't too complicated, and I don't anticipate after we restructure the board that we're going to have a problem at all.
I talked to some people who are, you know, but not.
Well, as you know, desegregation is not affecting us nearly so much as it is other school districts, largely because we are in compliance with our court order. We have a neighborhood school plan in operation in our school district without freedom of choice. That is, we do not have a minority-majority transfer rule, which means that all but one of our 180 schools are integrated at the present time.
And you see, this is the answer to the problems that some of the other southern school districts are having.
Without a doubt, the neighborhood school concept is the only defensible plan from a professional standpoint, that is, from the educational standpoint. The freedom of choice plan, which does not result in desegregation of schools, creates problems, and it seems to me that this kind of plan, that is, the minority-majority transfer rule, ought to be eliminated in these plans.
Well, our school system is like it is all over the country. We have a drug problem here, and we realize this, and I hope everyone else does realize that we do have a drug problem. Everything from glue sniffing, dropping pills, smoking marijuana, and some of these individuals are even shooting cocaine and heroin.
Now, we're hearing a great deal about this back east, about some addicts dying from overdoses or impure heroin or something else. Have we had any real bad incidents here in Fort Worth so far?
We've had a couple. I know one 19-year-old who died here last year, overdose of heroin. We've had one youngster die here from glue sniffing, and also one 15-year-old girl who died from sniffing Freon glue gas. This is not as bad a problem as it is in the East, but at the rate we're going, I'm wondering if it soon will catch up. We've had almost a 200% increase the last 2 years in our cases filed.
The people have a right to be involved in any decision to offset the higher cost of the new City Hall through the sale of the existing City Hall. Our city of excellence cannot become the eternal city overnight if we spend people's taxes with reckless abandon and without the consent of the people. A modest amount can and should be interpreted only by the people, as is their right through a bond election. $1 million extra for the new city hall may not be considered a modest amount by the majority of Dallas people. The city charter provides that a bond election may be called within 15 days to 30-day period. The bid specifications provide for a 60-day period to award the contract. Therefore, I propose that we consider calling a bond election immediately after the bids are received, if an overage occurs, as is indicated by the estimates of the architects.
I'm unfortunately not too optimistic that in 1970 Congress will pass a revenue-sharing program. President Nixon recommended to the Congress in 1969 that the House and Senate should act affirmatively. But this Democratic Congress has not acted affirmatively on revenue sharing. It hasn't acted affirmatively on the crime bills. It hasn't done a lot of things that should have been done. But I can say this, if we get a Republican Congress after this election in 1970, we'll pass revenue sharing in 1971, and we'll do it quickly.